Greetings. This is your brother, Elder Black Light. This goes out to all my beautiful black original Asiatic brothers and sisters trying to wake you up into the knowledge of self. And they don't talk about this in black history. They don't want to talk about how they breeded Negroes or niggers from a scientific approach. Just like you breed animals. You can breed a thoroughbred horse if you know the science of it. Willie Lynch was one. But we're going to get into why we shouldn't be attacking each other and why that black men shouldn't join the military. They shouldn't join being politics. Matter of fact, we should just sit this out, just like we, when you work on a job in a factory or any other place, and when you get united, when you be in the union, the boss ain't treating you right, then you go on strike. Yeah, we on a big plantation, and we need to unite and go on strike. But first we got to see why we are acting like this. Some of us are pro plantation, some of us are not. So check this out.
I'll take the affirmative. Take the meanest, most restless nigger. Strip him of his clothes in front of the remaining male niggers, female niggers, and nigger infants. Tar and feather him. Tie each leg to a horse facing an opposite direction, set him on fire, and beat both horses until they tear him apart in front of the male, female, and nigger infants. Bullwhip and beat the remaining nigger males within an inch of their life. Do not kill them, but put the fear of God in them, for they can be useful for future breeding. Anybody know who Willie Lynch was? Anybody? Raise your hand. No one? He was a vicious slave owner in the West Indies. The slave masters in the colony of Virginia were having trouble controlling their slaves, so they sent for Mr. Lynch to teach them his methods. The word lynching came from his last name. His methods were very simple, but they were diabolical. Keep the slave physically strong, but psychologically weak and dependent on the slave master. Keep the body, take the mind. I and every other professor on this campus are here to help you to find, take back, and keep your righteous mind.
To hear The Willie Lynch Letter and The Making of a Slave, read by Ronald Eastwood. Contents. Chapter 1. Greetings. Chapter 2. Let's Make a Slave. Chapter 3. Cardinal Principles for Making a Negro. Chapter 4. The Breaking Process of the African Woman. Chapter 5. The Negro Marriage Unit. Chapter 6. Controlled Language. This speech was delivered by Willie Lynch on the bank of the James River in the colony of Virginia in 1712. Lynch was a British slave owner in the West Indies. He was invited to the colony of Virginia in 1712 to teach his methods to slave owners there. The term lynching is derived from his name. Greetings. Gentlemen, I greet you here on the bank of the James River in the year of our Lord 1712. First, I should thank you, the gentlemen of the colony of Virginia, for bringing me here. I am here to help you solve some of your problems with slaves. Your invitation reached me on my modest plantation in the West Indies, where I have experimented with some of the newest and still have the oldest methods for control of slaves. Ancient Rome would envy us if my program is implemented. As our boat sailed south on the James River, named for our illustrious king, whose version of the Bible we cherish, I saw enough to know that your problem is not unique. While Rome used cords of wood as crosses for standing human beings along its highways in great numbers, you are here using the tree and the rope on occasions. I caught the whiff of a dead slave hanging from a tree a couple of miles back. You are not only losing valuable stock by hangings, you're having uprisings. Slaves are running away. Your crops are sometimes left in the fields too long for maximum profit. You suffer occasional fires. Your animals are killed. Gentlemen, you know what your problems are. I do not need to elaborate. I am not here to enumerate your problem. I am here to introduce you to a method of solving them. In my bag here, I have a foolproof method for controlling your black slaves. I guarantee every one of you that if you installed it correctly, it will control the slaves for at least 300 years. My method is simple. Any member of your family or your overseer can use it. I have outlined a number of differences among the slaves, and I take them differences and make them bigger. I use fear, distrust, and envy for control purposes. These methods have worked on my modest plantation in the West Indies, and it will work throughout the South. Take this simple little list of differences and think about it. On top of my list is age, but it's there only because it starts with an A.
The Supreme Wisdom Lessons by Master Farad Muhammad to his servant, the Honorable Elijah Muhammad, for the Lost Foundation of Islam in North America. To the Muslims of Number 1, Michigan. The following is the original rules of instruction to the laborers of Islam and the title of Muslim given by our Savior before his departure, with a footnote of a few words of explanation to lay pressure upon their minds of their many errors in the past and present, that they may see the light and walk therein. I thank you. Elijah Muhammad. Instructions given to the laborers by our Savior W.D. Farad Muhammad. 1. The student must study his assignment, lesson number 1. Each student should copy the answers of lesson of Minister Elijah Muhammad and study until the student is able to memorize by heart all answers to of said lesson number 1. Note. Here, lesson number 1 is said to be the student's assignment first.
So what?